it before somebody else kind of say, okay, good idea, you know, and then really work out the plan of action from there. I think the number one thing of all of it is really being willing to take some risks. And times being what they are now, Ron was talking about, you don't necessarily need to be reinventing yourself at this point. But I do think that looking away to within what you already do, kind of reinventing or improving or looking for opportunities, or in this case, the great relationships that you have built over the years here with the networking, it's essential, because you can't necessarily, I mean, during the 90s and part of 2000, if you kind of had any kind of business, you were going to do okay. You kind of just got up in the morning and made sure you were there and things were going to work out, because times were like that. It doesn't mean it was an automatic success, but you were going to do okay. Now, thinking outside of the box has become so important. And again, there I think networking is so important. I remember when when we started the WPBA tour again, I was about 6 months before then, 3 months before, I got a phone call. And New York Times Magazine wanted to do an article on me. And to me, that was just kind of a local newspaper. Yeah, it's New York, but, you know, the local newspaper. So I said, sure. So all of a sudden, they had this woman, Alessandra Stanley. She came to my house and spent about a week at my house, which I thought was very strange. She just kind of followed me around, and, you know, it was kind of an interesting situation. And from there, she followed me to a tournament. I did a show on in a Montel Williams show when he first started out. I did a show out in L.A., and she came with me to that. And she started doing this article, and I was really glad for her to go home, because it's kind of, you know, tough to behave 24/7 when somebody's there with you. But then I got a phone call, and they said they wanted to do a picture for the article. And I was just about to go home to Sweden to visit my family, and I said, you know what, I am packing, I'm getting ready, I don't have time to do a picture. And they said, well, can you just come down to the pool room? I said, can I send you one of my promo shots? I said, I don't have time for this. Well, little did I know, I went down there, and he said, bring all different type of outfits and everything else, and I brought 6 or 7 different things. He picked it out, we did the picture, and it ended up on the cover, and it ended up as a cover story. And the great part about that is that we were ready. We had already planned this tour. We had everything in place. We weren't sure really how to launch it. But that article, you know, everything went crazy from there. That's a lot of the media that you were talking about, the Letterman, everything else came out of that. But it helped us propel the tour. But had we not done our homework ahead of time, if we would not have been ready, that would have been a hugely wasted opportunity. So again, what David was talking about, it's interesting to me, because this is the time to be ready, to get yourself ready, that even if you're not going to really, you know, hit it out of the park next week, this is the luxury right now, is to get yourself ready for when times do change, because we all know this country, it is going to change. So I think that for me, those are the main things that I ran into, that I was faced with, and I think that it goes, you know, across the board. It doesn't matter if you're an athlete, if you own a real estate company, if you are, you know, the manager of a supermarket. It is day-to-day type thing. You kind of look to improve, you look to do the best that you can, you figure out a way to network, you talk to people, you know, as far as leading the business, it's the same thing. You set up your goal, you work your way backwards, get on the 1, to get on the 2, to get on the 3, and so forth. Now, I do want to do one more thing before we wrap it up, and I want to have a chance to, I have a flight going out today, but I want a chance to meet some of you outside as well, and maybe answer some questions. But I have one shot that is really important to me, and I know that you guys may have seen this. And I was thinking to myself, who do I get to volunteer for this? And who do I get to help me with this shot? And, you know, to me, there's only one person I'd like to bring up here, because I checked out his teeth earlier, and they were nice and straight. So I think we got a good shot of pulling this off. David, Genovese, would you like to help me with a shot? I wasn't sure if you were going to, you know, bail here, David. I think you know what's coming, right?
I think I do.
Okay. How's your dental insurance, David?
It's paid off.
It is? Okay, very good. And we're covered too, right? BCA is covered. Okay, we're covered. We're good. All right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have you stand right here. Mm-hmm. Turn your back to your fans.
Okay.
Okay, perfect. Just like that.
Okay.
Now, if you don't mind, you can leave your coat on if you want. That makes you feel better.
It makes no difference. Yeah. Okay.
Scoot up and sit right there. Okay, you're not going to be working that much anyway, so. All right, next part. Just go ahead and get comfortable, David. Perfect. All right. And that's a good thing, too. Those are like natural teeth, because sometimes if they've spent a whole lot of money on it and there's a miscue, trust me, it's not good. All right. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to balance three pieces of chalk on the rail right here. You're good with this so far?
I'm good so far.
Okay.
It's when you start putting it in my mouth, I'm going to get a little screwed.
Well, if you're going to take off, you better take off now, because pretty soon you're not going to have that opportunity. Move a hair closer to me. No, just like that. Okay. I'm going to put this over here. All right, David. Hang in there, buddy. On top of the three pieces of chalk, I'm going to balance the cue ball. That one. Did you hear that?
I heard it.
Okay.
I want to know what your dental gas is.
Move just a pinch closer, just a hair. There you go, perfect. Then I'm going to take this chalk. I'm going to clean it off a little bit first here, David, just in case. Oh, can you open your mouth? Perfect. You need to hold it with your teeth. There you go. I wasn't kidding about that. And then wrap your lips around. Yeah, that a little bit higher. That's more to prevent bloodshed than anything else. Okay, I'm going to take the nine ball. We're going to balance the nine ball on top of, actually, David's going to balance the nine ball on top of the chalk. Oh, that's pretty good. Okay, from here, it's downhill, David. I'm going to shoot the cue ball, about 72, 73 miles an hour, off the three pieces of chalk, into the nine ball, making the nine ball in the corner pocket. No, this is more for your sake than for mine. All right, all looks good for me. Are you good?
Mm-hmm.
All right, don't nod. Here we go, nine ball in the corner pocket. Oh, David, we missed it. Now, I told you I get three strikes. If I need 181, I may have to use them. We're going to make this shot, David. Strike. You good?
I'm good.
All right. All right, he still has his teeth. There's no blood. I didn't even have to convince him about this part this time. All right, here we go. One more try. I feel good about this one, David. Here we go. Nine ball, corner pocket. Come on, baby. Like that. How about a hand for David Genovese? Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you so much again to the BCA and Phoenix and everyone here for having me. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Fantastic. Come on, let's hear it for Ava one more time here. Come on now. Phoenix, welcome. And we are going to also welcome our sponsor, David, kind enough to bring in denture cream. How are your teeth doing with that? You know, real quick, I got to tell you, because she is a history book of experiences. Jackie Gleason had game. He was a phenomenal billiards player. Paul Newman was really good, and out of curiosity, Color of Money back in 86, Tom Cruise couldn't play at all. Very interesting. And she was a consultant on that movie, but really, what a cultural icon here, and what a pleasure to experience these many stories. Again, thank you very much, Ewa. Now, we're also going to tell you that she's going to spend a few minutes on your way out for autographs and a few photos, so keep that in mind. And we also have a winner we've got to announce. Come on up.
Our door prize this morning was provided by GPE. It was a $150 gift certificate to the Melting Pot, and the winner was April Llewellyn. So come and see me afterwards. Congratulations.
Again, I want to thank all of you for coming, and again, I can't emphasize enough the very simple message, the value of networking, sticking together in these times, working together, not only socially, but business-wise, and I want to thank Ron and David for making me part of this experience. This was really unique and truly memorable. Thank you all for coming. Ewa will be over here in the next few minutes for autographs and photos, and thank you, GPE Companies. Appreciate it very much. Ron and David.